hit bulls out of kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. Well, hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, Pass Math with Ms. Passarella. I'm your favorite math teacher, Ms. Passarella. And today we're going to talk about compound inequalities. And compound inequalities are when two or more inequalities represent a situation using the words and or or. Oh, is that a knock at the door? Who could that possibly be?
Well, hello, Ms. Passarella.
Well, boys and girls, this is my teacher bestie, Mr. Neiro. He teaches English.
You're making a video right now?
I am making
a
video.
You're adorable.
No, you. Oh, Mr. Neiro, can you tell us, even though nobody really likes literacy class?
Excuse you?
Even though we don't like literacy class, can you give us a few pointers on solving or writing compound inequalities?
Well, yeah. Listen, kids, if you're solving word problems, make sure you use context clues in order to find the best possible answer using your time wisely.
Well, that was wonderful advice, Mr. Neiro. Thank you for showing up.
Thank you for having me, Ms. Passarella. And no one likes math.
Everybody likes math.
Just kidding.
That was so nice of my bestie, Mr. Neiro, to stop by and give us some advice. And let's see if we can apply it to the word problems we're going to do now. Today's learning target is I can graph compound inequalities and represent their solutions in different forms. So the first example I'm going to go over is an and situation. And the second example I'm going to go over is an or situation. So I'm going to go ahead and read the first one. Example one is and. And represents a set of numbers that go in between two numbers on a number line. The word problem is the average ages of students who attend a particular high school are older than 13 and at most 18. So this is two separate inequalities. So I'm going to go ahead and write them as separate inequalities and show you what kind of symbols to put in between them. So the first one, the ages of the students who are represented in this high school are older than 13. So if X represents the ages of the students, and 13 is the age we're comparing it to, I know they're older than 18, so that means I'm going to use the more than or greater than symbol. And now the second inequality that represents these students, so again, X represents the students' ages, and 18 is the number we're comparing it to, or the age we're comparing it to. And if they're at most 18, that means they could be 18, which is equal to, but 18 is the most, so the other numbers are going to be less than, or the other ages, they would be less than. So it's going to be less than or equal to. The reason now I know that this is a compound inequality is because it's going to have the symbol and in between it. And there's two ways you can write a symbol and. It looks like an upside down V, that's the first way. And I like to remember that because it looks like I'm about to write a capital A, I just didn't cross it, you know, all the way across. The second symbol I can use, I'm going to write the same exact inequality. So X is greater than 13, and X is less than or equal to 18, except it looks like an upside down U. Also could be a capital A without the cross. So that's the first set of symbols I could use to represent this compound inequality. I want to say the most common way would now be to represent it on a graph. So I'm going to do the first thing. I'm going to graph both of them. And I'm going to show you how they kind of connect together. So you're kind of putting a limitation on the ages of people in this particular high school. So if I'm going to graph this first, I'm going to circle the 13 because X is greater than 13. So I'm not going to shade that in because it's not equal to. And then I'm going to shade in the 18 because the 18 is equal to. Now, if it's greater than 13 but less than 18, all that means is I'm going to include all those numbers in between. So for the 13, I'm going to shade it to the right. And that means for the 18, I'm going to shade it to the left. And all these numbers are included in this number set. So if I were going to write a list for this, I could see that 13 is not included. 14 is included. 15, 16, 17, and 18. This is also known as a set roster, and again, that's just a list, and you're going to put French braces around your number set or your list. A French brace, it's not a parenthesis, it's not a bracket. It looks similar except for it's fancy. So it looks kind of like this. That just means all of these numbers are listed in your set, and you would know that because they would be surrounded by these braces here. All right, the set builder. This is kind of tricky. The variable is always going to be in the middle for a set builder. So again, we set it with symbols, we represented it on a graph, we made a list, and now we're going to do a builder. A builder just means when I originally had my two inequalities here, but they had two different variables, x and x, or I wrote x two different times. But right now, I want to simplify that, and I want to only write x one time. So I'm going to put x in the middle. I'm going to put my low number on the left. I'm going to put my high number on the right. And if I take a look at these inequalities separately, for example, x is greater than 13, and x is less than or equal to 18. In this situation, Pac-Man was eating 18, so I'm going to keep that symbol the way it is. However, the other symbol, if x is greater than 13, I needed to flip-flop that around. Remember, when I was going over the previous inequalities lesson, I said I didn't like the variable on the right-hand side, but in this case, you're going to have to put the variable on the right-hand side compared to the smaller number. So we're just going to switch it around. If Pac-Man's eating x compared to 18, I'm just going to inverse that sign here. So right now, it reads 13 is less than x, which is less than or equal to 18. And to complete a set builder, there's a line that separates it. This x, and that just says that the numbers in this set, which are represented by x, or the ages within this set, and I'm going to also surround that with the French brace. A shortcut to knowing that your set builder is an and situation is that both of the symbols will be less than, and the smaller number will be on the left, and the larger number will be on the right. So if you see that both of the symbols are less than, you can automatically assume that it's an and situation. All right, interval notation is a little bit tricky. It almost looks like it's a coordinate for a coordinate plane, like you're going to graph it, but that's just not true. So I'm going to go ahead and compare it mostly to my inequality symbols and to my graph. So the way you would write an interval notation for this situation is you write your small number on the left, comma, your larger number on the right. And if the number is not included, you're going to put a parenthesis, and 13 is not included, so I'm going to put a parenthesis on the left-hand side of that. And then 18 is included. See, it's shaded on the graph here. This one was not shaded, so it's an open circle. So if it's a closed circle and it also has that equal to symbol, in the inequality, you're going to put a bracket. So these little details matter. So again, when I put parentheses, that means it's not included. But when I put a bracket, that means it's included or shaded. All right, now I'm going to go over the opposite situation, and the opposite situation is or. So it's kind of like it's this or it's that. The opposite word problem I'm going to deal with here, the average ages of students who do not attend a particular high school are 13 and younger or 18 and older. And an or situation just excludes a set of numbers. So you're going to actually see two separate graphs on one graph, where an and situation, there was just the one graph. You could see that here. All right, so let's take a look at this. Let's pick it apart. Let's use our context clues like Mr. Neiro told us. And if X represents the ages of the people we're dealing with, the ones who do not attend high school, they're either too young or they're too old. So they're 13 and younger, which means 13 could be included. So I've got X, I've got 13. And if they're younger, that means I'm going to use less than or equal to. Now the next inequality dealing with the 18, so I've got the ages of the people compared to 18, they're older than 18. So if they're older than 18, that means I'm going to use the greater than symbol, but I'm not going to include 18 because they in this high school they had to be older than 18 not to attend. And the first symbol I'm going to show you, if I compare it to the and situation. So and, the first symbol looked like an upside down V, where if it's or, it's just going to be a V in between. And now the next one, I'm going to write this again using the U. I don't actually remember what these symbols are called. If I remember, I'll look it up and I'll put it in the comment section below. So I'm going to rewrite it exactly the same way. So I've got x is less than or equal to 13 and x is greater than 18. And I'm just going to put a U in between. That means the word or. All right, now I'm ready to graph on my number line. In this situation, you are going to see two separate graphs. The first one I'm going to be dealing with is with the 13. So I'm going to circle the 13, and I'm going to shade it because it is included. Remember, they could be 13 or younger. And then I'm going to go ahead and shade it to the left. And this represents the ages of the people who are too young to be in this particular high school. The second inequality is the 18. So the ages are greater than 18. So I'm going to circle the 18 because that was the number in my inequality. And now the older people would be to the right. So I would shade it this way. All right, so now I'm going to write the numbers that are in this list. And I'm actually going to have to write two lists since it looks like there were two graphs. So I like to start off with the smaller list. And I know if I have a smaller list or if it's going to be a less than situation, I'm going to have my dot, dot, dot on the left-hand side, which technically represents negative infinity, even though you can't really be that age. And now I'm going to write three numbers leading up to the 13, including 13. So I've got age 11, 12, and 13. I'm going to surround it again with the braces. And then I'm going to put an or symbol in between. It doesn't matter which symbol you put. And now I have to write the list for the larger set because remember, I'm excluding the ages here. So these ages here are excluded. These people are in high school. And remember, we're graphing the people who are not going to high school. So I can't include 18 in this list because it's not shaded. So the first age after that is 19. Then we've got 20 and 21. Dot, dot, dot on the right means positive infinity, even though you can't be that for an age. Oh, that brace looks terrible. All right. You don't have to be perfect at writing those either. Just kind of make a squiggly line. All right. Now I'm going to write a set builder. And again, a set builder is both inequalities with one variable in the middle or in between them. So I'm going to do exactly that. I'm going to put x in between them. I'm going to put my small number on the left, which was 13, and my large number on the right, which was 18. And if I look at the two inequalities, it was x is less than or equal to 13. So if I were to compare this on the set builder, remember Pac-Man is eating the 13, or Mrs. Pac-Man I like better. So I need to flip-flop it when I put it in the set builder so that Pac-Man is still eating 13. So I'm going to go ahead and inverse that sign here. So now it reads 13 is greater than or equal to x. And now I can keep the other inequality the same because the variable is on the left-hand side, which is where I like it. So I'm going to go ahead and keep that. I'm going to now put all that fancy stuff around it. So all these numbers in the set, I'm going to put it, I'm going to surround it with braces. And that's pretty much it. So if I were going to look at this again, remember the low number or the smaller number is on the left. And the large number is on the right. And if you were going to look at this as a shortcut with that situation, if it's an or situation, you're going to have two greater than signs. So right here and right here. That means or, if you were going to look at a shortcut. Since there were two inequalities on the graph and there were two lists, if I'm going to write an interval notation, I'm going to actually need to write two of them with a symbol in between. So if I look here, again, the parentheses were not included and the bracket was included. So I'm going to compare this to my list. And if you take a look right here, the dot, dot, dot on the left-hand side always stands for negative infinity. So that's the first number I'm going to include. And then the other number in that particular graph was 13. Negative infinity can never be included, so that's going to get a parenthesis. And in this case, 13 is included, so I'm going to give it a bracket. Now I'm going to put the or symbol in between. I'm going to put the U shape just to be different from right here. And now I'm going to put the first number in the set, not from the list. I'm not going to put 19. I'm actually going to put 18 because that was the first number I was dealing with from the word problem. So I'm going to put 18. And then all the way to this right here stands for positive infinity. So comma, positive infinity. Positive infinity, again, can never be included. You couldn't like plot a point at infinity. So I'm going to put a parenthesis. And 18 was not included. So I'm also going to put another parenthesis. So again, let's take a look. We have and situations and or situations. We wrote everything with symbols. We then graphed both of the situations. We represented as lists, set builders, and interval notation. And they all literally mean the same thing. It's just a different way to represent it. It's a whole lot of math language, as much as I don't like literacy. I hope this helped. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, tell me I'm adorable, and make sure you leave a comment below. See you guys again soon.